Bonjour, Barbara.
Bonjour, Hannah.
No problem.
Hello, Hannah.
Ça va? Et vous?
Ça va, merci. Et votre week-end?
Très bien. Et le vôtre?
My weekend was good.
Ça s'est bien passé.
Allez, retour.
OK, so...
Je vous laisse parler.
Good morning. How are you?
Good morning. I'm fine. Thank you.
You already said you had a good weekend.
Yep.
So, yeah, I also did.
OK, great.
All right.
Alors, ce matin, vous parlez de revenus.
Well, what do you have for us this morning?
On se dirige vers la fin de l'année 2017.
As we head towards the end of the year 2017, the Ethiopians today celebrate September 11th, their new year 2010. Yes, 2010. This is a religious holiday in the country. Return to it in a moment. This religious festival is an opportunity to take more a global interest in religion and spirituality on the continent. And I have 5 minutes to talk about it. The continent is known for its religious favor, and Africans are very much on spirituality, whatever form it takes. But the majority of the people on the continent are followers of Islam or Christianity. Christianity in Africa also has different forms, and Ethiopia is an example of that. I told you earlier today that they are celebrating the New Year's Eve 2010. Over their Christianity is dominated by the Ethiopian Orthodox Church, and the country follows a unique calendar in the world. And while Christianity was introduced in Africa during colonization, in Ethiopia this is not the case. It is one of the oldest Christian countries in the world, and it is also full of ancient sacred places in the town of Lalibela, which is somewhere the Jerusalem of Ethiopia. Another sacred site, but completely different, this is a sacred forest of Osogbo in Nigeria. For the Yoruba, it is a place for pilgrimage with a river dedicated to Osun, goddess of fertility and love, who recently greatly inspired the singer Beyoncé. This forest has a dual interest, both religious but also cultural, because it contains works of contemporary art. And this is what makes the originality of this forest, which is classified as a UNESCO World Heritage Site. We do a little sightseeing there, and I encroach a little bit on the travel segment, so I stop there. But the sacred forest precisely allows me to smoothly transition to ancestral African religions, and that's where it's sometimes a problem. Why do I say that? Well, because they are scary. As soon as one speaks of animist religion, some have only one word in their mouth, sorcery. Many Africans themselves do not know the difference, and that's why we go to Gabon, where they have Bouti. It is a religion based on the consumption of iboga, a plant that has hallucinogenic virtues that is supposed to treat addictions like drug abuse. We hear a testimony of two people from Western.
I also had addictions that last a long time, which were treated about a year ago. But I'm still very fragile, and I would like to finish with that. We learn a lot about the nature of life, the universe, and especially about oneself personally. It answered many of my questions.
As usual, we now go to photography. I would like to tell you a little bit of a story of everyday life in pictures. So it's happening in South Africa in the midst of apartheid, and it is a story of a train, the Soweto line that connects the Soweto township every day to the center of the capital of Johannesburg, a long, sometimes dangerous journey carried out by black South Africans. And on this train, morning and evening, the journey turns into collective grace with preaching and gospels. It changes the silence that generally prevails in public transport. The photos were taken by the South African photographer Sancho Mofokeng. We finish with the color and series of photos, Minaret's Hats, by the photographer Mark Warsi. His models are carved with hats in the forms of minarets. They are towers in mosques that serve to call the faithful to prayer. The minarets here are colorful to show the diversity of cultures gathered around a religion, Islam. So, this is a view of the religions on the continent. That's all for the Culture Chronic. We meet in a few days. Goodbye.